this week's agronomy update. My name is Jason Hackbart. I'm a sales agronomist at the Manly, Iowa location. Today we're going to talk about soybean herbicide application timing. Today we're going to start off talking about the stage of soybeans because that is very crucial to determining what herbicide to use. In our area, we had a lot of soybeans this spring that didn't get their pre's put on due to the fact the planters were basically running right up until the rain started, and then we had a long extended period of cold, wet weather, and then the soybeans began to crack and emerge before we could get the pre's on. So it's very important to stage your soybeans at that point in time to determine you're using the right herbicide. So number one, you don't kill them, and number two, to do the right job. I had a lot of customers in our area ask me a question about planted soybeans. We had rain and a cold period for about 2 weeks. Once it was dry enough again to get back out in the field to spray herbicides, the soybeans were cracking through the ground. So at that point in time, pre-emerge herbicide is no longer an option. You have to go to early post-emerge. So next, I will show you how to stage a soybean plant and how to properly determine where it's at so that you can use the proper herbicide. I went out and dug up a few plants to show you exactly how to stage a soybean plant. I did notice that it was hard to find one with the cotyledon leaves still on it. Right here you'll see the cotyledon leaves on this particular plant. The others were kind of turning yellow and falling off. The first leaves that emerge after the soybean comes up is the cotyledon leaves. The second leaves that come out are the unifoliate leaves, which are a little bit easier to see on this particular plant right here. These are what you're called your unifoliate leaves. It's a single leaf, normally opposite of each other. These are kind of at 12 o'clock and 9 o'clock on this particular plant. But anyway, and then we progress on to the what they call the trifoliate leaves, which is a cluster of three leaves. When we had our issues this spring with the soybeans emerging before we got the pre's on, we had to wait until these leaves or the unifoliate leaves were fully emerged before I would tell guys to go out and start applying herbicides. The reason for that is the soybeans, when they're in the cotyledon stage or just emerging, they're very sensitive and very susceptible to crop response from the herbicides. Soon we'll be using PPOs, which more commonly called FlexStar GT, Warrant Ultra, products like that. That product can only be used once a year. The active ingredient, fomosafen, which is in both of those products, has a limit to what you can use per year, and also there's a 10-month rotational restriction on those products. Many of you have chose to use the new dicamba-tolerant soybeans this year and also incorporate the dicamba products on those acres. For many of you, this is new. We've been going to a lot of meetings about this, so we try and stay in constant communication with all the reps so that we can best inform you of what are the best management practices for these products. A couple things that are notable, pay attention to wind speed, boom heights, tip selection is very crucial, and one really important thing, no AMS. Make sure if you have any questions about these products that you contact your local AFS agronomist. Thank you for watching this week's agronomy update. Have a great day.